The first thing to understand is that we have been created, it is said, in the image of God. Well, for the purpose of working on creation, for the purpose of perfecting creation, for the purpose of perfecting the planet, for the purpose of converting the planet to a paradise. Are we doing this? Are you doing this? Well, then we need to look into what's going on in that area. We are saying that if one of these heroes, the champion who beat the other one, the one or who hit 400 home runs in baseball, or the softball leader or whatever, the soccer ace or golf ace, whatever, comes to town, you know, we are moving in such a wrong direction that immediately these people are idols for many in town. Some businesses will close because their idol is in town. Newspapers send reporters. Radio stations send microphones. Television send their cameras. Universities send their bands to form parades and so forth and so on, because the one who hit 400 home runs are in town. Or the champion number one who knocked everybody to the floor and couldn't get up anymore in boxing is in town. Now, when have we ever done this to individuals who saved humanity millions of hours of suffering and thousands of lives, such as the ones who discovered sulfa, penicillin, and the polio vaccine? Oh, we don't parade these individuals. Sometimes we don't even know that they're in town and they leave. Is that fair? That's a good question to ponder on. Now, when we keep in mind, when we're moving in the wrong direction and you get in trouble and you ask whatever you call God for help, do you think you qualify to get it? Are you really measuring up to qualify and get this kind of help? A good question to ponder on. Think about that. So then again, why haven't we corrected our problem? Why haven't we learned our lesson? You know, Noah and the ark, you know, way back in time, it is said that maybe we were so far gone that somebody upstairs decided to go back to the drawing board, wipe out everything, start over and over again. Well, right after that, we continue making the same mistakes and not understanding what we're supposed to be doing on this planet. Moses came along, tremendous commandments, but we don't mind them. We continue making the same mistakes and continue going in the wrong direction. Why? Are we not capable of understanding? Are we lacking some mind development to understand that? Here comes others, Abraham, Isaac, Joseph, big issue, you know, trying to correct this problem. But nothing happened. They came and left. We continue making the same mistakes, continue getting into trouble the same way as though they never came. All these big name individuals, spiritual individuals who have come, you name them, Krishna, Zoroaster, Buddha, Muhammad, Jesus, trying to correct problems for us. They came and left, and we continue moving in the wrong direction. Right now, we have created so many problems that we really do not know how we are going to get out of them. That's for sure. Now, we need to make some changes somewhere along the line. Maybe we need to become geniuses. Maybe we need to completely change our way of thinking, different perspectives and so forth. Something's got to be done, or else we are moving in the wrong direction towards complete, total destruction of this planet. So then, stress to begin with. Why have we gotten ourselves in these stressful situations? Again, do we have enough brain power? Do we have enough intelligence to understand what we should be doing and not be doing and so on? Well, to begin with, let's go back again and into our development. We're saying that mind has developed up to a certain degree. Talking about the catabolic cycles, we should live a lifespan of 98 years. It is said the 7x7, anabolic cycles, 7x7, catabolic cycles, full lifespan, meaning when a plum converts, you know, into a prune kind of thing, you know, when grapes turn into raisins, well, this is the anabolic and then the catabolic. And we should die in perfect health. Die. We should just take off, not die. In our sleep, just move on to some other dimension. We call it die sometimes. Well, we say that what shortens the lifespan of planet Earth? Health problems. But if we solve all health problems, we're going to die in perfect health because diseases are not going to kill us. In our sleep, we just take off and that's it. You're in another dimension now. This is what's happening to millions of people per year. Everybody per less than 100 years. Anybody who's alive now will not be here 100 years from now, and that's it. So, again, moving into the direction of mind development. We were saying that what is going to neutralize your stress? Do the right thing. And what is the right thing? Get busy in making corrections on the planet. Try and correct problems, as many as you can. Your problems, anybody's problems. As you become aware of a problem, it is your responsibility to start thinking in the direction of solving it. Whether it's your problem or anybody's problem, it's a problem detected on planet Earth, and you are the keeper of planet Earth. So then, every time you solve a problem, you get a reward, you see. Now, why is this? We need to use more of our brain to really understand this. I think that now that we're using both left and right brain hemispheres, which only 10% of humanity by natural means developed the use of, and the many people that we in mind control have trained, have taught to use. You see, we have 7 million now, over 7 million. But 7 million is a drop in the bucket when you talk about 5 billion. And saying that only 10% of them are naturally using both brain hemispheres. Maybe this is the reason why we did not understand what Noah meant in the time of the Ark, or what Moses meant, or any of the big individuals, big by big spiritual individuals, highly evolved individuals, who I feel were sent to planet Earth to correct this moving in the wrong direction problem. That the main problem was in only using the left brain hemisphere to think with, not the right one. When the right one has to do with the invisible world, and there's more invisible than there is visible in the universe.